The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to our new live webcast, Lean License Management by SAP. Join us each month for new powerful messages, technical tips, and success stories that will leave you inspired and ready to get your protection, licensing, and security techniques on other steps closer to perfection. My name is Daniela Previtali, Global Marketing Director of VB Systems, and I am delighted to have you here with us today. We are joined by Rüdiger Kugler, VP Sales and Security Expert at VB Systems, and Harry Ritzelmeier, CTO and Technical Executive at Informatics Holding. The integration of Codemeter License Central with SAP, the world champion's business suite, offers a significant advancement in back-office performance. License and entitlement management are incorporated within the existing workflow. The ERP system is enriched with automatic features for generating license codes, transmitting them to the user, and tracking their activation. Some housekeeping we need to take care of before we start. For everyone who's joining us today, I want to remind you that we will be reserving some time at the end of the session for Q&A. And I'd like to invite you to submit any question you have in the live chat box. This session is being recorded, and a link to the replay will be posted directly to you in the next couple of days. And don't forget, stay with us throughout the live session for your chance to win an Amazon coupon worth 50 euro. At the end of the webinar, a new tab in your browser with three simple quiz questions will show up. You can submit one choice for each multiple answer question. We will draw the winner from among those who reply correctly and notify them at the time of the replay announcement. Please also note that the winner is excluded from all subsequent prize draws of 2018. Without further ado, I'll pass things over to Rüdiger. The floor is yours.
Yeah, hello also from my side. My name is Rüdiger Kügler. And in the next 60 minutes, Henry and I will tell you something about a small introduction about Informatics. So who is Informatics and what did they do in the projects together with Vibo Systems to integrate Codemeter and License Central together. Then we will have a small overview about Codemeter License Central, how it works and how information data is transferred between License Central and SAP. And then in the main part of our webinar, we will take a look at the different use cases. And the first use case is creating and delivering licenses. So how to create, deliver a license from you as a software vendor to your user. The second use case is the rehosting of a license, the relocation of a license by your user. So let's assume your user wants to change his equipment, his computer, and then he wants to move the license from the old computer to the new computer, from the old machine to the new machine, something like this. And how can this happen? And what is the communication between License Central and SAP in this case? The third use case is very close to this second use case. I want to migrate a license from one computer to another computer, but let's assume the first computer, the old computer, is already lost. What do I do in this case? The fourth use case, changing licenses, is something like subscription licenses. So I want to renew a subscription or want to add some more functionality or want to remove parts of the licenses or all the licenses. And so changing an existing license. And last but not least of our use cases, reselling and reusing licenses. And here we have two different options. One option is you are using a reseller, so you don't sell directly to your end users. And so you sell to a distributor, reseller, and the reseller is selling the licenses, your equipment, your machines to your end users. And you want to have some more information about the end user, and you want to have a link in SAP, which end user has now which software, which license. And the second thing is one end user just resells or sells the license to another end user. So let's imagine you have a machine and the software belongs to a machine. And then this user says, oh, I no longer need the machine and I want to sell it to another user. And then couple of days, years later, the new owner of the machine calls you and says, oh, I have this beautiful, great machine from you. And I have this software with the machine, but I need an update of the subscription, something like this. And last but not least, we will tell about a typical approach, the typical steps in a project. So if you say, oh, this looks great, and I want to integrate SAP with CodeMeter License Central. In this case, what can Informatics do? What can Vivo do? And what are the typical steps in such an integration project? So let's start with the first topic on our agenda, a small introduction of Informatics. Henry, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Rüdiger. Welcome everybody from my side as well. I'm Henry Ritzelmeier from Informatics Holding. Informatics Holding is a classical SAP consulting and development company. We are a certified SAP partner up to the PCOE partnership, which basically means that we also do first level support for certain SAP customers in the name of SAP. Therefore, we have know-how across all standard SAP modules like SD, MM, and all the others. Our company stands for Quality, Information, and Trust. But that shouldn't be the topic for today. The topic for today is the integration of CodeMeter License Central within SAP. So what did we do here? We developed a class framework, which is in the NetWeaver ABAP stack, which uses all standard CodeMeter License Central interfaces. Those interfaces are certainly customizable, and there are also some standard process modules already included, which are used for the typical use cases like creating tickets and other stuff like that. But we will see more of this in the upcoming slides. The whole development done is in an own namespace, and therefore we have no interference when we transport this class framework into the customer's SAP system.
Yeah, now let's have a small overview about CodeMeter License Central and when and where and how data is transferred. And so let's take a look at this picture. On the left-hand side, we have you, the software developer, software vendor, and you have your SAP system. And on the right-hand side, we have your user, your customer. And typically, your user has your software, and you can have a license portal so that your user can see which license did I purchase, and where is the license installed, where is the license activated. And from the license portal, there are different versions. The lean version is Web Depot, which can be just customized to your look and feel. So it's a very easy solution, which you can use in a couple of seconds. So it's just a click away from using it. And there are extended license portals like our user portal, where you can have an user management integration. So a lot of stuff. And today for this demonstration, we will use our Web Depot, so the lean solution, to show how the activation works. But of course, this can be integrated in your software or even in more extended license portal. And of course, in the middle, License Central, which can be hosted on your side. So License Central could be on your data center, or Vivo Systems is offering License Central hosted in the cloud. So you can say, I want to have the software as a service solution from Vivo Systems. And in this case, we will operate License Central on your behalf. By the way, the on-premise solution and the cloud solution is exactly the same. So it's quite easy to migrate from your own hosting to our hosting, or to start with hosting at Vivo Systems and then later migrate it to your own facilities. So, but now let's take a look how it works. So, and SAP is sending an order to License Central. This includes a customer ID. This includes a list of items, so a list of goods, a list of licenses, which should be created. And then License Central is creating a ticket and sending the ticket back to SAP. By the way, if License Central is hosted in the cloud by Vivo Systems, in this case, we secure this communication via encrypted communication. So it's a HTTPS encryption. And we are using a client certificate to make sure that your instance of SAP is really your instance and nobody else has faked an account and tries to connect to us. And so it's encrypted via HTTPS and authenticated via a client certificate that you on your side use for your SAP if License Central is hosted in Divibo Cloud. But now let's go back to the process. So we're getting the order, we're sending the ticket back, both encrypted, and then you can send the ticket to your customer, and the ticket looks like a Microsoft activation code. It's a 5x5 digit string, so A, B, C, D, E, minus, F, G, and so on. And I think Henry can explain more in detail where we can store the ticket in SAP.
Yeah, sure I can, Rüdiger. But before I start the explanation, I have to do some clarification. When we talk about order, we are not talking about a production order or a sales order, which is transferred to License Central. This order is a CodeMeter License Central order. The trigger within SAP can be any object where an event is triggered. It could be a sales order, it could be a production order. In our examples later, we will use the equipment, the event of the creation of equipment for the further on processing, but this order is not an SAP order, just for clarification. So when this trigger is started within SAP, and as I said, in the further example, we will use the creation of an equipment for our process, then the information which is transferred to License Central comes from the equipment and also from the attached information to the equipment. License Central is processing this CodeMeter License Central order and sending us back the ticket. So where is the ticket stored within SAP? Usually the ticket is stored within the same object which initially triggered the order. In our use case later on, this will be the equipment again. So what do we do with the equipment? What do we do with the ticket? We store the ticket in the equipment in a field with an appropriate length. As we can see in the process three, the ticket is 29 digits long, including those four little dashes between the five characters. We will use some field which is capable of storing 29 digits. Question for you, Rüdiger, does a ticket necessarily have to be that long?
No. So this is our standard format of a ticket with the 25 random chosen characters. So from the security point of view, we say 12 is the minimum. So if you want to reduce the ticket, you should not be less than 12. Another option is to say, oh, I want to store some information in the ticket. So for instance, the last two digits should be a checksum and the first three digits should be a characteristic of the ticket, like this is for an OEM, this is for a direct end user, this is this product family. And so you can say I'm using special digits of the ticket for some additional information. But at the end, you should have at least 12 randomly chosen tickets from the security point of view. Yeah, but now the ticket is sent to the user, and this can be done on different ways. I remember one project where the ticket was engraved on a small chip card, and then the card was sent to the user. Another project, our vendor just created pin letter, so it's an envelope which is really heavy to see, so you can't see the content of the letter even if you put it on the window against the light. And so they are sending this pin brief. In other projects, in a lot of projects, they are just sending a simple email to the customer. And here I got a question: oh, what happens if the email gets lost? It's a ticket that you can use for one activation. And so if the activation is done by someone else unauthorized, then of course you can recall the license. We will see this later. And you can give the real customer a new license. And so it's just in the major use case, the ticket is used only once. And so if a ticket gets lost, it's not a big issue. There are ways around to create new tickets and to get back the licenses connected to the old ticket. And even if some one unauthorized has used the ticket, the license is bound to his computer or to a dongle, so we know where it is. And so it's not a big issue if a ticket gets lost. But let's now continue with the real process. And so our user goes to the license portal, or he starts the software. And then there's a question, please enter your ticket, please input your ticket. So and then our software, our runtime is creating the fingerprint of this machine or the fingerprint of this dongle. It depends on soft license or dongle based license. And then this fingerprint is sent together with the ticket to License Central. So and now License Central performs many checks, a lot of checks. The first check, is this a valid ticket? Is the ticket already used? Which licenses are in the ticket? The fingerprint, does it belongs to a known machine or to a known dongle? Or is it a new one? Is it a real fingerprint or is it a fake fingerprint? If it belongs to an existing machine, are there some automatic updates which should be added to the license creation automatically this time? And so there are a lot of checks done. And if everything is all right, then License Central creates the license, which in this case is a VBU CMRAU file. It's a VBU CodeMeter Remote Activation Update file. And this license file or license update file, programming file, is sent to the user. And then the software is importing it, or in the license portal, this can be done automatically. And then the process is done from License Central point of view. But at the end, License Central can or is sending a notification to SAP back so that SAP now knows, yes, the license is now activated, so I can change the status of the equipment. And the License Central now knows where is the license. So in which CodeMeter serial did we activate the license? And this is the major overview of the process and of the data flow between SAP, License Central, and the user. And now let's go to the different use cases, and let's start with the creating and delivering licenses use case. And we will see that this is very close to the process which we already described as the overall process. So let's take a look first. We're creating an order in SAP, as Henry mentioned. This does not need to be in a production order, doesn't need to be in sales order. It could be any trigger, but in License Central, this will create a new order. So then SAP automatically creates or transfers data to License Central. And what happens if the items in License Central does not exist already? So to create licenses, you need to have some items. We call this our articles in License Central. And if these items are not there, SAP is able to create these items automatically. Or if the item is already there, but the item needs to be updated because it's outdated, SAP can update the item also during this transfer process. So then it's going back to SAP, and Henry, you store the ticket number somewhere in SAP?
Yeah, that's correct. In our example here, we will store the ticket just in a field with an appropriate length for the ticket itself, but it doesn't necessarily have to be a field. It can also be like the configuration of the equipment or the classification of the equipment. And also there is the possibility if the customer has extended this equipment with any append structures, and there are fields with an appropriate length, of course, again, then we can store this information in those fields. As mentioned before, optionally, we can store additional information like the ID of the license or any other information which is coming back by creating those order.
Yeah, and now the ticket is delivered to the user. This can be done, as mentioned, via SAP, maybe email, maybe a printed engraved card, or maybe this PIN letter, PIN envelope. And then the user is activating the license. In example, he can do this via WebDepot, but of course you can integrate this activation process also within your own software. And then License Central is sending the notification back to SAP. And we prepared a small live demo to show exactly this process. So I go to SAP, I already started SAP. And the trigger here in our example is the creation of a production order. So we'll create a new production order.
Oh, you lost your connection.
The connection is lost. Okay, I need to log in once again. So not a big deal. So it's 400, it's Vibu, it's the password. And we want to switch, of course, to English. So, okay, so now we will do it again, create production order. So, and we will have to choose a material. So which license do we want to create? It's a 10, 10 to 1000. Production plan is 0001. And then the order type is PPO1. So now the order is connected to SD order. And so we need to pick the right SD order. This is a test system, and that's why it's the order ID 1, and the position is the 60. Okay, and we want to produce one type, so it's a production just in time for one license. End date, that's great, and we say continue. So now we need to go to the header and to serial numbers. We create a serial number automatically. So, and now we need to make sure that the equipment is created also automatically. I'm pressing F5, please create equipment automatically. We will need to remember the serial number 75. Okay, we can click okay here. And now everything is fine and we can save our order. So now in the background, SAP did already transfer data to License Central, did already got the ticket back, and the ticket was already stored in our equipment. And so I need to go back to the initial screen. So when we want to see the ticket, then we go to the equipment. Now we need to search for the equipment. And you remember, it was the serial number 75. And so let's search for the equipment with the serial number 75. And this is the equipment 378. So now let's go to this equipment. So and then we see that this ticket isn't here yet. And I think this is a very good thing to explain the mechanism in the background. Henry, what happens if the connection between License Central and SAP doesn't work properly?
Yeah, well, first let me explain a couple things here. We created a production order, and this production order triggered the creation of an equipment. The creation of the equipment itself triggered the communication to License Central. So this is all is an asynchronous process which is started in the background. The asynchronous process is usually processed by the so-called event queue within SAP. So what this basically means that since you don't see the ticket yet here, obviously this process hasn't finished yet. In the meantime, the event queue is processed by SAP step by step. And, oh, here we see it already. The process is obviously already done. The sort field is filled. So the communication to License Central and back to SAP has been done. One important thing to note here is that whenever something happens, like we have a communication problem or any other interference with the communication between SAP and License Central, this information that the equipment should trigger an order within License Central is not lost. It's stored within the event queue. Standard SAP reports are capable of reapplying those events in a case of a problem at any time later on. So the process itself never gets lost.
Okay, so now we have the ticket. And now let's continue with the activation. And so now we would deliver the ticket to our user. So in the user, as I mentioned, can go to WebDepot. He enters the ticket here, and then he clicks on next. And then we see we have two items here. And this is an interesting question, because in SAP, I just used one item, so one material number, the 1010-2000. But here I see two items. Henry, could you explain why we have two items here instead of the one item in SAP?
Yeah, sure, I can. The trigger, as said before, is the initial creation of the equipment. And this equipment is basically a serialization of the master data of our material number we entered, that was 1010-2000. But we didn't create a license for 1010-2000. When we take a look later on in the equipment, we can see in the configuration data that this material is a configuration, a configurable material. Ah, you're doing this right. That's perfect.
Let's do it now.
Yeah, let's do it now. So what we can see here in this configuration, that this equipment has two characteristics. And those two characteristics, or basically the characteristics value, which are the key of the licenses, are transferred to License Central. That's why you see two items within License Central and only have one material and one serialization, one equipment within SAP. That's the reason why you see two items.
Okay, so this explains it very well. And so the message is it also works with a configurable material. That's, I think, a really great message. So, but now let's go back to our Web Depot. Now we know why we see here two items. And then we can click on Activate License. By the way, Web Depot has some options that you can say you're not allowed to activate base product on one machine and extension server on another machine. But in this case, I think it's okay here. So now for the demonstration, I already prepared two soft containers with the serial number 503 and 504. I picked the first one with the 503. And then I will say activate selected licenses now. So now all the things happen in the background, which I already explained. The fingerprint is created of this machine. It's sent to License Central. License Central checks, is this a real ticket? Is the license already taken? Is this a real fingerprint? Are there some automatic stuff for this fingerprint? Creates the update file, sends it back. I'm not so fast in explaining, then this happens. Now the license is imported, so it's locally on the system. It's applied to this container. And now we are creating a receipt and we are uploading the receipt. So at the end, License Central knows, yes, the license was really activated. It was not just delivered. There's a receipt. And so we know the activation process now is confirmed. So we see here in a Web Depot that the container is the 503. So now let's go back to our equipment. I think I need to close and open the equipment once again, display equipment. And we put this information into other fields. And here we see it, the manufacturer serial number is now filled with the CodeMeter serial number of the CodeMeter container. Yeah, of course, this is just one sample here. The serial number of CodeMeter can also be filled, of course, in other fields. And so this is just a sample for a field which can be used for the CodeMeter serial number. So this was the first process. Let's take a look at the next process, rehosting or relocating licenses by the user himself. So and here we have three different use cases. Let's assume the computer should be replaced and you know, okay, I'm getting a new computer tomorrow. Haha, great new computer. And I want to move the license from the old computer. So I want to remove it on the old one and I want to put the license on the new computer. And this is something that License Central allows the user to do himself. And so you don't need to interact. You don't need to do something in SAP, you don't need to create new licenses. You can just do this autonomously. But of course, you see how often he did it, when he did it, and how we did it. A second use case is, let's assume we have licenses which we have assigned to an employee. So let's say there's a development environment, and I got the license because I used this for a project. And after half a year, I'm out of the project. And let's say my colleague Jörg is taking my part in the project. So maybe he needs to get the license. And so I need to move the license from my computer to his computer so that he can use the development environment on his computer. Or, and this is also a very interesting topic, let's assume I got two CodeMeter dongles with different licenses. By the way, this could be even different licenses from different software developers. And I want to put them all on one dongle. And in this case, I also like to move or rehost licenses from one dongle to another dongle to have only one dongle in my pocket and not to have a complete chain or ring of keys. Yeah, and so the message is the user can do this himself in WebDepot. And of course, you can say, I allow this, yes or no. This is a setting in License Central. And of course, we will send a notification of the rehosting to SAP. So also here we have prepared a very small demo. So let's go back to our web depot. We see the button rehost licenses. And now when I click on rehost licenses, I got a message. Rehosting means we have two steps. The first step is to deactivate the license from the old computer, from the old machine, from the old dongle. And then you can activate them again on the new one. And so please deactivate selected licenses now. I do this. And after the process is finished, we are sending the notification to SAP. And SAP now can change the status of the equipment and removes the serial number from the equipment. So now I activate the license. And for this, and that's the reason why I put two container on my machine, I want to simulate this rehosting of a license. And so I'm now selecting the 504 and say, activate selected licenses now. And now the same things happen in the background, just all the checks and uploading received, everything is fine. And now the licenses are in the 504. And when we switch back to SAP, we need to close the equipment and need to reopen the equipment once again. And now here we see, now it's in the 504. So, and that's the whole magic of rehosting a license. The user can do it himself, and we report back to SAP what happens and how often did the user do this. Let's assume that our user forgot to deactivate the license and the computer is now gone, it's lost, it breaks down, is retired, got retired. Or another use case is, let's assume a dongle got lost. I had a case, I guess it was 10 years ago, where a dongle was lost in a big fire in Australia. And so the user was calling then the software developer, the software vendor, I need to have a replacement license, can we do this? So in this case, the software developer authorized another activation in SAP, so a reactivation. And I guess Henry can tell where to put such a button for the reactivation.
Yeah, sure, I can. The thing is, when you want to do a reactivation by SAP, you usually do this in the same object as initially created the licenses. In our use case, this is the equipment again. So within the equipment, we can authorize a new reactivation either by changing a status, like a user status or something like that. Of course, we can also add some kind of functionality to the equipment. On the right-hand side, on the pane, you can create processes which can be triggered by when you are in an equipment. You can press this button to do the reactivation. Usually this is done within SAP because When a customer loses something like the dongle or computer breaks down and he calls into your company, the people which are picking up the phone usually have access to SAP. So they are used to the SAP transactions and they know what they can do and where they can, where things can be done. And another thing here is that the typical user doesn't necessarily have to have access to another program or to another website to do this reactivation. And the third thing, of course, is if you do the reactivation or trigger the reactivation within SAP, you'll also have the history within SAP. So you can look up, in our case, in the equipment, in the history of the equipment, has a reactivation already been issued, let's say a month ago? Is it this the first time the reactivation has issued? And if you can see in the history, well, this is already the third reactivation, you might have some typical questions to your customer why this is already this third time.
Yeah, and after SAP has authorized the reactivation of the license, the user can do this himself in WebDepot or, of course, in your software. And then we are sending the reactivation or notification about a reactivation back to SAP. Alternatively, you can use the interface of License Central to authorize a reactivation. So you can do this manually in our graphical interface. And there are some rules for automatic reactivation, like I'm allowing one reactivation per year, one reactivation per month, depending, of course, on your settings and on your requirements. Of course, also all this manually or automatically reactivations authorized automatically in License Central will be sent back to SAP. So even if you're using the manual processes or automatic processes in License Central, every information is reported back to SAP. But as Henry mentioned, in most cases, it's more interesting, more convenient to integrate also the authorization in SAP to have everything under the control and to have only one system for your users, for your employees, so that they don't need to learn the interface of License Central and SAP. So most of them are already familiar with SAP. And so let's do them everything in the system with which they are already familiar. Yeah, now let's go to changing licenses. And changing licenses, we have three different use cases that we identified here. And the first is extending license. So I already have a license and I want to get more. Let's have, say I want to have an additional feature or I want to have an additional license, something like this. So, and the important thing here is to combine two licenses, we need to have the ticket or the original order ID, and then we can combine the license from the first ticket with the new license by putting the same license into the same ticket once again. So, and here Henry is updating the equipment in SAP.
Yeah. In our example, as you probably remember, we have an equipment with a configuration. So this equipment has some characteristics value already assigned. The updating here in this example would be to change the characteristics or the value assignment of the characteristics. So basically, when you want to extend an already existing license, you go into equipment, go there into configuration and add some additional value assignments to your characteristics. This is the trigger, which then again issues an order to License Central and adds within this order those licensing to the existing ticket, which we have already seen within the equipment.
So then the additional licenses or additional items are added to the existing ticket. So now the user can go to WebDepot and with the old ticket, he can activate also the additional licenses. Of course, WebDepot or License Central is sending a notification back to SAP about the activation of the additional license. easy and simple. So now let's talk about updating licenses. And updating licenses, in this case, we have three different things where we think updating a license could be interesting. Let's think about subscription models. So you're selling your software on a monthly, yearly, quarterly base. And short before the license expires, you want to renew the license. And so SAP knows, yes, this contract is still valid or the customer has paid. And so SAP triggers us and tells us, please renew the license. And in this case of a subscription model, similar to a subscription model is a maintenance contract. In this case, the license does not expire, but let's say the update right expires, so the maintenance expire. And if the customer don't renew the maintenance contract, in this case, he stays with the old version. Or let's imagine the third case of different editions. Let's say we have a standard edition, which includes Word and PowerPoint, and you want to update to the professional edition, which includes Word, PowerPoint, Excel, and Access. And in this case, also the license needs to be changed from the old license, the standard license, to the new professional license. So in this case, we need the ticket and we need the license ID of the license, which should be updated. So, and then Henry, SAP does, I think, very similar things.
Depending on the use case, basically. I picked the simpler one, which is edition is changed from standard to professional in your examples. Of course, this would be again a change in the configuration again. A little different approach would be the time-based, like a subscription model or something like that. Within the equipment, we have also additional data like warranty information. So like warranty begin, warranty end, and stuff like that. If you use this, or if you have this use case, you would probably apply the new data, like the warranty end, to the equipment within the warranty information. This helps if you do it this way for certain post activities, post processes like maintenance contracts within SAP, which can use those information for further billing processes.
So in the license center, the old license now gets replaced by the new license. And there is a very interesting feature. Of course, the user can also use the old ticket to activate and replace the old license with the new license now. But there's also an auto update, because License Central knows this old license was activated in the CMACT container or in the dongle with the serial number 504, which ends with the 504. So now if the serial number 504 appears on License Central, License Central now knows, there is a replacement, so the old license should be removed, the new license should be added. And so even if the user does some complete different action with this container, he will automatically get the replacement of the license. And there's an API function, so you can implement the check in your software. When the check says, is there an auto update available for this license, for this container? And then your software can automatically update the license and gets the renewal of the licenses in this case. So this is, for instance, very interesting if we think of such a subscription model. And so the user just simply starts the application. And I guess every user or nearly every user should be online once per month. And so once per month, your software could check, is there an auto update available? And so the user just has a subscription. He doesn't see anything, he doesn't do anything, and the license gets renewed automatically in the background, and SAP is triggering it to License Central, and your software activation wizard or your software automatically picks the renewal from License Central using this auto update. And of course, last but not least, we should not forget to remember that after the activation, we will send a notification back to SAP, so that SAP now knows, yes, this license is now activated and the renewal or the replace took part. And the third Use case groups of the changing licenses is withdrawing a license or withdrawing licenses. And let's assume the user doesn't pay for a license and you want to have the license back, or the user wants to return the license to you and wants to have his money back because he purchased something wrong, some not satisfied expectations, something like this. Don't know why, but these are two different use cases. And let's assume you want to return the money or you want to get the license back because the user doesn't pay. And in this case, also the ID or IDs of the licenses which you want to get back, which should be withdrawn, must be known in SAP. So, and then SAP is locking the equipment.
Yeah, usually in this use case, we will use within the equipment the status net, where you have available, locked, invalidate, and stuff like that. You can also use a user status for that, or a business process which brings the equipment into this user status. So you can see within the SAP system also that this equipment is locked, which means that the ticket and therefore the licenses within the tickets are locked.
So then the old license gets withdrawn. Of course, this withdrawal can be done by the ticket, but I guess that no user would do this with a ticket. And that's why in this case, the auto update, which I explained for the replacement, would be the better choice. And so your software will check automatically, is there an auto update? And oops, now the license is gone because the license was withdrawn from you as vendor, and it would be removed from this container. And of course, last but not least, we are sending a notification back to SAP. The last group of use cases, reselling and reusing licenses. As already mentioned in the introduction, we see two different use cases here. Let's say use case one is you have a reseller or a net of resellers. We have many resellers all over the world, and you are selling your software via a reseller to the end user. Then when you create the order in License Central, you only know, oh, I gave this license to this and this reseller, but you don't know who is the user, but maybe you want to have a user registration, which is one of the possible add-ons for WebDepot that you can force your user to register, and then you can put the information back to SAP and then saying, okay, this license now belongs to this end user. The second, also very interesting use case, which happens very often if you're selling a machine or if you're selling a device, and then users can resell this device or this machine to other users. So let's say it's a laser cutting machine and I'm using this machine very successfully for 2 or 3 years. And after 3 years, I say, oh, I need a new machine because I want to have a bigger one, a faster one, something like this. But a friend of mine or someone else says, oh, the old machine is still okay for me, and it would be great if I could buy it, rebuy it from you. And then my friend is buying the machine from me, and then he is using this machine. And now a couple of months or years later, he finds out, oh, there's a software with the machine, and I want to have the current version, or I want to have a maintenance contract for this. I want to add some additional features. And then he is calling you as the vendor, and then you say, I don't know you, and this machine should be not at your site. And then you find out, okay, this machine was reused or sold by user from user to user. And then you want to exchange everything in SAP and want to make sure that SAP now knows that the new user now is the owner of the machine and that he is allowed to add a maintenance contract and something like this. So, and here in SAP, we are assigning, or Henry is assigning the license now to a new partner.
Yes, that would be the most convenient way to accomplish this. The equipment has, again, as an additional data, a partner management. So So within an equipment or an equipment can have certain partners like a customer partner, vendor partner, stuff like that. In our use case or in our process, this reselling would be within SAP an assignment of the partner customer to a different customer. If the customer doesn't exist at this particular time, of course, you first have to create it, your new customer, and then you can assign it to an equipment. Therefore, you have all the information within SAP to create the new maintenance contract or some processes like this.
Yeah, and in License Central, we got this or get this new order with a new customer, new partner, new user. And we will create a new ticket for this. And then the licenses are rebooked from the old ticket to the new ticket. And we think creating a new ticket is a good idea in this case, because if we just move the old ticket from one user to another user, the old user would still know the ticket. And so he could do some evil things with the ticket if he wants to do this. And so the new ticket is only known by the new user. Everything now is great and easy, but the history is still there. So we know that this license was in the old ticket, now it's in the new ticket. And another reason for the new ticket is, let's assume that with the original ticket, the original user purchased two machines, but he sold only one of them. And so if we would keep the old license in the old ticket, we would have now a ticket which belongs half to one user, to the old one, the original one, and the other half of the ticket belongs to the new user. Makes not really sense. And that's why the idea of creating a new ticket is a good from the security point and also a good idea from the workflow point. And of course, in SAP, the new ticket needs to be stored in the equipment. So the equipment is updated in SAP also. Yeah, last but not least, how does a project look like? So when you say, oh, we want to use CodeMeter and we want to integrate License Central with SAP. So how is the first step? So and the first step should be a short phone conference between informatics, Vivo, and you. And then we find out what are your basic requirements, what can we do for you. You get an impression, can we do this together, does it make sense? And after this short first phone call, the next step would be a workshop with informatics and Vivo Systems. Mainly it's done on your side. And the idea of this workshop is the first to start to get all people on the table. So the license management, licensing staff people, then the SAP and process people, the technicians, the developer who implement everything in the software. Of course, Vivo Systems with the experience in how to protect and how to license software, and informatics with the know-how of how to implement such licensing processes in SAP. And then to develop a common understanding so that we speak the same language and think of the same things. Then we need to analyze your current processes and your requirements, and you need to tell us, oh, we want to change everything, or it should be as close as possible to the current process. Then, of course, you define which license models you want to get, which license models do you want to use. And then we can pick the fitting license options, which we call the product item options, in our CodeMeter universe and say, okay, for your subscription, we need the expiration time. For this and this, demo licenses, evaluation licenses, we need usage period. For the network licenses, we want to use the license quantity with borrow, without borrow. And so we will pick the right options for you, or we will help you picking the right options. And then, and this is the part of informatics in this workshop, we need to map your SAP processes to the processes in License Central. So, and after this, you have a very clear picture of how you can integrate License Central with SAP. And then you can decide how to do the integration. And there are different options available from informatics.
Yeah, that's right. Usually, depending on the current workload of your IT department, those available options can be used depending on the workload, as said. The first would be we deliver a turnkey solution. So we deliver our class framework, we do all the process customizing, and sometimes also development for certain user exits and stuff like that. The second option would be we just deliver the class framework and your IT department does the process integration. Therefore, the IT department can focus on your processes and how your processes should work within SAP and doesn't have to think about how the communication within from SAP to License Central has to be done, because this is done by the class framework. And the third option would be you implement everything on your own, and informatics is here just available to advise.
So I saw there are already a few questions in our chat window, and let's go through the questions. I think the first question is something to you, Henry. Why do we need a production order for a software product?
Okay, that's a good one. Well, we don't need a production order for a software product. We just use the production order here in our example to create an equipment. Of course, an equipment can be created from any other processes within SAP. You can either create an equipment on the fly, or you can create an equipment, let's say, in the purchase order or in the delivery or stuff like that. We just use the production order here to show how an equipment can be created with an SAP system. When we take a look at the field and at certain customer projects, a production order is not that far away from the typical use case. The reason is pretty simple. Usually, when you sell a software or you sell a firmware, you also sell the software or firmware for a specific hardware, and therefore you should already have a production order for your hardware. And therefore, we will use the production order just again, as we could see in our example, and at a particular time to create our equipment. But you don't necessarily have to have a production order.
A second question, and I guess this is something that I should answer. Must it be SAP which sends the ticket to the customer? No, it should be SAP, but it does not need to be. So typically, License Central doesn't know about customers. So License Central only has a reference to a customer ID, and not the complete information like email address, phone number, and so on. Because this information is already stored in SAP, and why should we have the same information twice at two different places, which means synchronization and a lot of effort for this. So that's why we say, okay, make it as lean and as simple as possible. And that's why we only have the information about a customer ID. But there are additional fields in License Central, and so SAP could also hand over the email address of the user to License Central, and then License Central can send the ticket directly via email to the user if you want this. And so it doesn't need to be SAP, but in most cases it's better that it is delivered by SAP. I remember just one project, and in this project we have an online portal, so a license portal, and not Web Depot, the extended version of Web Depot, which is the Web Depot is the basic of every license portal, and in this case there's an extension with a user management, and at a time when the license is created, the user is already known in SAP, and so not the company, really the user to which it should be connected. And then SAP is sending us the information of the user ID, and then we will add the ticket automatically to the user account in this extended portal. And then on the next morning or the next second, the user logs in to the license portal, and then he blop sees his new license or his new licenses in his portal. And in this case, there's no ticket sent between SAP and the user. SAP just sends to License Central please combine this ticket or this license with this user account, and then the user only needs to log in. And in this case, we don't need to send the ticket to the customer via SAP. And so the answer of the question, no, it doesn't need to be SAP. License Central can send the ticket, or License Central can assign the ticket to existing user accounts. But in most of the implementations, we are sending the ticket back to license to SAP, and SAP is sending then the ticket to the user. The next question, I guess it goes to Henry. Can I use a different object than an equipment?
Yeah, certainly you can already also use a different object than an equipment. An equipment just has some features which, well, could be used pretty perfectly for a container for licenses. Like as we saw in the last couple slides, we have warranty information, which is sometimes useful. We have partnership management, as we could see, sometimes useful. And also we have a container for a classification or for a configuration, also useful. But it doesn't necessarily have to be an equipment. If your license models are more simpler, if you have containers which are more simpler, you can also use like an item of a purchase order or an item of a delivery as a container for those licenses. Depending on the processes or the complexity of the processes, sometimes the equipment is very useful for that, but it doesn't necessarily have to be an equipment.
And this last question, and I guess I should answer this this question. What is the license ID? Is this the product code? The product code is the code which is checked in your software. So if you have the same feature for two customers, they would have the same product code. But the license ID is an individual ID for every license for every user. So let's assume I'm selling the item 1234, or the item 1010-2000. I sell this to Henry, and I sell the same item to myself. So in this case, we would get two different IDs. So Henry would get the license ID number one, and I would get the license ID number two. And so later on, if we say, oh, Henry doesn't pay his invoice, and so we want to remove the license, then we need to know, oh, we want to remove license number one, the one which is owned by Henry, and not the license number two, which is used by myself. And so that's why I need an individual ID for every license. And on the interface, this is called the ticket license ID. And so it's a unique identifier for every single license. Or let's assume Henry has different employees, and he got one ticket with three licenses, and then we have three license IDs. So it's really an individual identifier for every single license. I see there are no more questions in the chat. So thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much for the lot of questions that we got here. And I like to say bye-bye, and hope to hear and see you again in our next webinar. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you from my side as well for joining the webinar. And depending on the time zone, have a nice morning, noon, or evening. Thank you.